In this video, learn how to use joystick to move player on phone game. How to create a touch area for joystick. How to use on pointer move to get touching position. How to get direction and angle from two points in 1 second only. Joystick direction is axis horizontal and axis vertical to move player. Angle to use in any top-down game or 3D shooting game. How to move white touch icon to touch position, and how to limit it inside joystick icon only. Multi-touch work perfect too. Last video, we learned how to move player on phone. You can watch again with link under video. On player controller. Disable all other controllers. And turn on touch controller only. If you press play, you can move player with these touch button now. Let's replace moving button by joystick. Create an UI image. Name it touch area left. Make it size big enough to cover all the screen. Then move it to cover half of screen. If you touch on white area, joystick will be activated and move player. I will turn it to black and reduce opacity for you watch it easier. Last video, we learned how to detect on button hold on phone. Add the script to this touch area left. To detect if touch area left is on touching, you can add its name right here. It will work right away. But this video, we need to get touch position when touching. And this touch position can get from this event data only. We have touch enter and exit, not on hold. So we need to add one more listener for touch hold. Or you can use touch move listener instead. Whenever button is on touching and moving, event on pointer move will trigger. Select implement interface to add this event into. Now you can get touch position when button is on hold or touching now. To check if touch area left is on touching, we check if this script is on object touch area left. If it is on touch, print out touch position. Control S. Save your script. Press play. If you touch on right side, nothing happened. But if you touch on left side, you will get touch position on object touch area left. You can make this touch area left invisible now. You can get these icons free under video. Make sure they are set as Sprite 2D and UI. Create an UI image. Name it joystick area. Add joystick icon into. Make it size bigger. Move it to left corner. Reduce opacity as you want. On pointer event can detect button on top layer only. So make sure touch area left is at top layer. Next, create another icon. This icon will show you where you are touching on the joystick. It will have shape of circle. Adjust its size as you want. Create new C# script. Name it Joystick Manager. Add the script into object joystick area. Open it. Remove unnecessary code. Create new void event on joystick touching. It will receive current touching position as input. Whenever joystick is touching, print out the position at touch. We will call this from another script, set public to allow using it. Now on object touch area left, whenever you touch on this area, on pointer move will trigger. Let's send touch position to joystick manager. Find and add component joystick manager to a variable. You can call anything from Joystick Manager now. Send touch position to Joystick Manager. Add touch position into. You can delete this message. Touch position will be sent to Joystick Manager. Press play. Nothing happens if you touch on right side. Touch position will be showed if you click on joystick area. You can get this code under video. Copy all of code. Paste it into Joystick Manager. You don't need to understand the code, because you can get this math easily anywhere from Google. To move player, you usually use axis horizontal and axis vertical. They are exactly this direction between from touching position to center of joystick icon. We already have touch position here. Because this script is inside joystick icon, you can get its center position easily by transform position. Press play to test. When you touch on joystick area, you will receive axis horizontal and axis vertical now. These values are what you need to move your player. Most of top-down game or 3D shooting game, you will need to find which angle that player is moving to rotate player. You can easily get this angle value with event angle between two points. Let's get angle from center position of joystick icon and touching position. This is exactly angle that player is moving to. Angle will be counted from 0 and 360 degree, as you learned from school. Right side is 0, left side is 180 degree. In our 2D game, we need to use joystick direction only to move player. Let's add joystick direction to a variable to call it easier. You can delete this line of code. In some game, you just need to apply this direction to axis horizontal or axis vertical on your player controller, and it will work right away. But on this 2D game, we move player left and right only. You can do this way to move our player. If you touch or right side of joystick, player will move to right. And if you touch on left side of joystick, player will move to left. If joystick is not on touch, player is stopped movement. Open player controller script to see how to move player. In our game, when button right is pressed or true, player move to right. And when button left is pressed, player move to left side. When no buttons are pressed, player stops movement. Now let's add player controller script into our joystick. Name it player controller component. When scene is loaded or on awake, find component player controller and add it into this variable. To move player to right on player controller, you just need set value of button right to true. If button right is pressed, means button left will be false, not pressed. Same thing to move player to left. Now button left will be true, and button right is false. To stop player movement, both button left and right will be false. Let's see how it works. Touch joystick area, player can move now. It moved to left right correctly. But when you don't touch on joystick area anymore, player is not stop. The reason is, you apply touch position whenever touch area left is on touching. But when touch is ended, we didn't reset this touch position. Now when touch ended or touch leave joystick area, reset joystick touch position to 0. Apply touch position at center position of joystick icon. Press play to test. Move player, then not touch joystick anymore. Player can stop movement. You can use joystick to control player perfect now. Let's make white circle. Follow touch position anytime joystick is pressing. Let's add object touch icon into a variable to call it easier. Hold and drop touch point icon to variable on joystick manager. Every time joystick is pressing, move touch icon to touch position. Create new void event move touch point icon with input is touch position to move icon there. Add new void event move touch point icon. Simply move touch point icon to this touch position using transform event. Whenever joystick is pressing, white touch point icon will move to touch position. But in most of game, touch icon will be limited inside joystick area only. To do that, on joystick area, we need to add a collider for it. Its shape is circle, so we choose circle collider 2D. Turn on is trigger. Adjust radius size for this collider to cover all icon. Go back our script. First, add that circle collider 2D into a variable. Name it collider 2D component. When scene is loaded or on awake, get component circle collider 2D and add it into this variable. Now let's limit touch point icon inside joystick icon. Create new variable with type vector 2, or just var for any type. Name it closest position. This event will return a position on joystick icon if touch is outside of it. Finally, move touch point icon to this closest position. Press play to test it. Touch point icon is limited inside joystick icon now. You can build and run it on your phone, or connect your phone to PC and use remote to test it. Open Unity Remote 5 on your phone, then press play on editor. You can use your phone to move player now. You can jump while moving player as well, or while moving, keep running and jump at the same time. Multi-touch works perfect. You can turn off joystick icon to see it easier. Reduce opacity of touch point icon. It look like any games on store that use joystick now. Don't forget to subscribe my channel to save this video. Thank you for watching, and see you in next video.